Okay, hello everybody, and welcome back to another War Thunder upcoming content video. So yesterday, or actually it was yesterday, holy shit, it's now 9:08 a.m. and when I woke up I did a dev vlog on, or I did a video on the upcoming content for the FLAC 37, and I also did a video on the sneak peek. Well, we saw most of the stuff that is coming, and you know, I was expecting them to of course put out more dev blogs on these vehicles, and well, here we go. The A1E1 Independent. This will be a premium. It's important that I get that out of the way first, so to let everybody know, because a lot of people, the first thing they want to know is premiums, and I don't blame them. I mean, you know, that's something I always want to know. This will be a premium British tank. Let's go ahead and take a little bit of a closer look. Let's see if we can find it where it'll say premium. Well, shit, I don't know. So let's go ahead and open up the video here. And, oh, look at that, you can see the thing in there. It's got guacamole for a camouflage. But, hey, he didn't really show too much of it. Let's get a closer look there. It's moving. Looks really weird. Oh, it looks really weird. I'm not sure how I think about this thing's looks. But, hey, you know what? It's not the looks that matter, is it? Pardon, sire. Would you mind looking at this wonderful piece of machinery over here? I'm sure that was supposed to be in an accent. It is the Vickers A1E1 Independent, an influential multi-turreted tank design built by the British engineers. And it looks god-awful. British tanks played a pivotal role during the end of World War I, and the British Army was searching for new designers to further embrace this new idea of tank warfare. The Vickers A1E1 was built between the two world wars as a heavy tank concept with multiple turrets. It combined firepower, protection, and speed so necessary for the role of a heavy combat vehicle. Only one was ever built, and it was never used in battle. Although its children, quote-unquote, were this tank, was often the target of industrial espionage and heavily influenced some of the other tank designs produced by the other countries. For example, the German multi-turreted thing, which I know is Neubau Fart Zeug, I don't know. And the T-35, this thing actually influenced the production of the T-35, both already implemented within our game. Okay, the A1, okay, here's some more information about the actual vehicle itself instead of history, which I know some people like the history stuff. I do too, but I usually do that, read that crap in my own time. The A1E1 was powered by an Armstrong something V12 petrol engine with a maximum of 370 horsepower. It could reach an impressive speed for its time of 20 miles per hour. 32 kilometers an hour, with its weight slightly exceeding 32 tons. Its maximum armor was 28 millimeters thick, and it was operated by 8-man crew. The A1E1 was armed with a quick-firing 3-pounder cannon, 47 millimeter, in the main turret. The other four turrets were equipped with a 303 caliber Vickers machine guns, while the left-hand turret at the rear of the vehicle could be elevated to engage low-flying aircraft. Okay, so one of these turrets is actually different than the other ones. It's interesting. So here's the thing up close. You can see the different machine guns there, and then the main cannon. It looks like there might be a machine gun in the turret, too. Is that what I'm seeing? I can't tell. It's not a good enough zoom in. This thing from the back, though, looks pretty cool. I like this, how slick it looks from the back. It makes me want the TOG 2 in War Thunder. Maybe someday. Maybe someday. The Vickers A1E1 Independent will fit very well amongst other multi-turreted tank designs in the low-tier British premium tech tree. It might not be as nimble as lighter vehicles or not as armored as most other protected ones, but it combines little bits into one big platform able to step into different combat roles. An 8-men crew and 28 millimeters of armor will allow you to withstand a lot of shots from low-tier vehicles. This is a breakthrough tank. It could be the leader that your team needs. Charge your enemies at the front supported by your fellow teammates and take some shots for your brothers in arms. Or just get completely fucking destroyed by an enemy bomber. Oh, sorry, it doesn't say that there, actually. The quick-firing 3-pounder cannon, which, personally, I love these British guns, is a great weapon that can be used against light enemy vehicles. Fast reload and relatively high penetration will force your enemies to search for cover, making any attack against you to be done in wolf packs. If you love unusual designs and often play low tier, kind of like somebody I used to know, but that's a discussion for another time, fast-paced matches, you will surely find this vehicle very interesting. It will meet other similar designs and compete in clashes that were never possible in history due to the implementation of more advanced and effective technologies. And that's it. That's the A1E1, guys. The Independent. Now, while I wish that the British would have gotten some more stuff, I mean, any new premium for them is good, and especially something I had never heard of like this is quite an interesting design, quite an interesting vehicle altogether. It's not one I think I'm going to rush out and buy unless I just have some extra money lying around or there's a big sale and I'm able to pick it up along with stuff. Right now, the premiums, the KV-122 and the BV-238 are the two premiums I'm going to be focusing on mainly when the update is released, because those just seem like the favorite ones of mine. I mean, oh, it's going to be so fun. This thing, however, while I think it's a good addition, I don't think I'm going to rush out and buy it anytime soon, unless, like I said, something goes on. We'll see. We're probably going to see a few of these in battles, especially in low tier, and it's nice to finally have some, you know, more multi-turreted tanks in, you know, now all three. Actually, no, the United States don't have one. The Germans, the Russians, and now the British will have a premium low-tier multi-turreted tank. And I don't know what one's going to fare the best. The Russian one... Okay, let's be honest. The Russian one is the most OP one. The German one's good because it has two cannons, and they actually have separate elevations, I think, don't they? I can't remember. But the thing is while this thing... While they all have different armor counts, it doesn't really matter at this tier anyways. It's like tier 5 ground forces. When you compare all three of them together, the Russian one has a derpy, low-velocity cannon that can carry heat. But then it's also got three freaking... Does it have... No. It's got two extra 45mm cannons. And you can point two of them forward. Or you can point the main cannon and then the 45, plus it gets machine gun turrets. The German one, all in one turret, gets the 75 or whatever, and then it also gets a little dinky 37 or something like that. This thing is only getting the 47mm, and while it's a good gun and has a high fire rate, I still think the dominant one is the Russian one. I mean, that's just my personal opinion. I think that thing can deal out more damage and take more damage than the other multi-turreted tanks in the game so far. But we'll see how this thing really fares once we get into battle. Yes, I know the dev server was open, and people were like, jump on the dev server. I had three or four people on Steam tell me the dev server was open, and some of them really wanted me to go over and join them. And I don't do the dev server, guys. I don't do the dev server. I don't really have any good enough reason as to why I don't, but I'm not interested in playing around with stuff before it's out. You know what I mean? I would rather let other people do that, and I'll just wait for the full update to come out and then mess around with the new stuff. I don't know, that's just how I do it. Okay? Bloody fuck. Let me do me, you can do you. Let me know what you think about the A1E1 in the comments below. If you're excited for it, or if it looks like a piece of shit to you, let me know. And if you haven't seen the sneak peek right over here on the website, you can go ahead and check it out. Here's what you can expect to see for the United States, for air and ground, for Germany, and for Great Britain, for the USSR, and for Japan, also two new locations. It's quite odd. I could have swore that there was a game coming out very soon that is super, super popular. I could have swore. I don't know. The Russians have vehicles we have not seen devlogs for yet for Japan include the P1Y1 Mod 11 and the J1N1 Mod 11 for the Russians. Ones we have not gotten devlogs on yet include the KV-122 Premium and the GAZ. For the British, we have not gotten a devlog on this thing or the Hudson or the FV-4202. For the Germans, we've seen everything so far except the RAKJ PZ to HOT. And for the United States, we have not gotten a dev blog on the T-20 or the M56 Scorpion. Now, back in the day, they used to not do a dev blog on everything that was new coming, but they've started to do that better and better. I remember back in the day, you'd always look at the dev blog, you'd see everything, and then the update would go out, and there'd be like three or four aircraft that weren't even talked about in the dev blog, and you're like, oh, free goodies! But, well, they don't really do that too much anymore, but I don't know what ones we're going to get a dev blog on. I mean, the T-20, I can kind of see that getting a dev blog. I think the ones that would be the most interesting for a dev blog would be the M56, the RAK, probably the Hudson and this thing up here, and the FV-4202, and I think the KV-122 and both the Japanese ones would be good enough for dev blogs if they had to choose some that they weren't going to do. There would only be two or so. And I hope we get to see more of this desert map here that I could have swore could be in some relation, because it's a bit of a coincidence that it's coming out right around the same time that... But who knows? The world may never know. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.